I can't see everyone, so I can't actually see who's
hands. Seconded up. By me.
Councillor Mayor Aldridge. Any discussion? All those in favour, if you can actually raise your hand on the screen.
Can you see everybody?
I don't know. I can't.
No. Ask them to say no if they don't approve.
If there's anyone who's voting against, please speak up quite loudly. Presentation of confidential minutes. Mover?
Yeah.
Moved by me.
Moved by the Mayor, seconded by Councillor Woodman. All those in favour? Okay, report 601, future report. Councillor Blackmore, would you like to report? Okay, Councillor Blackmore, and seconded by the Mayor. Any discussion on these? No. All those in favour? 602, page 11, recommendations of the Strategic Property Development Subcommittee.
Yeah, if I can withdraw that, please.
Sure, Councillor Buchanan.
I'm happy to move SPDSC 1 and 2 as recommended, and move SC3 in an amended form. And that is, because I'm so organised, I did send through a draft to the minute secretary to put before you. It should come up on the screen. So it's the recommendation regarding the Walkley's Road Corridor project, Madam Chairman.
I'm just waiting to see
what I'm proposing here. It's very similar to the recommendation, but part one is as recommended. Part two, rather than endorsed, to proceed to business case, that it's noted. Three, as printed. And four, after the word engagement outcomes, I'm deleting the words to be undertaken in parallel to the next stage of the Walkley's Road Corridor project.
I'll second.
Seconded by Councillor Woodman. Any discussion on this?
I think I bored you all to tears last week, Madam Chairman. Unless anybody has any questions, I'm happy to give a further explanation.
Anyone? I can't see anyone wanting one. Okay, we've got a mover of Councillor Cannon, a seconder of Councillor Woodman. All those in favour? Anyone against? I don't know. Okay. Moving on to 621, community request, dashboard.
I'll move that. Julie.
Councillor Woodman wants to move. Seconded by...
I'm seconding it.
Councillor Mayor Aldridge. Any discussions?
Yes. Julie.
Councillor Woodman.
Well, it's really just something that everybody knows I've been banging on about when we get these reports. So because we got the dog and cat management information through the other night and we had household numbers in it, I've been able to extrapolate the figures for the top 10 suburbs where requests were logged as follows for June 21, which is on page 23. We're always saying that the suburbs don't, it doesn't indicate the actual amount of problems that people are having because the suburbs have different populations. So there was a couple missing, but I can say that Parafield Gardens is 3.5% of their population, and it goes down to Salisbury East, 2.5% of their population, and there's three of them have 3.5, and the others are in between there, 2.7 Fingal Farm. So now I'm happy to see that there's not really any outstanding suburbs with issues, they're basically all very similar, which is what we really thought anyway, but the numbers don't indicate the percentage. That's all. And it was easy to do once you've got the actual number of households.
Yeah. Anyone else wish to speak?
No.
All those in favour?
Yes.
Carried, I think. I can only see three of us, so.
Oh.
Any other business?
No.
All right. Can I have someone move us into conference?
I can see 9 pictures on our screen.
Is there Councillor Duncan?
Yep.
Mayor Wolfridge? Councillor Bright is not here.
Apology, yep.
Cannon is there. Councillor Hood, what's there? There, Councillor Hood?
Yes, I'm still here.
Councillor
still here.
Councillor Ook. Hey, Councillor Ook.
Sorry, my bad. I was meant to text her. Sorry.
Councillor Ook is here. Councillor
Ook. If we can perhaps just wait a minute, Mr. Chairman, I was meant to text Sarah when we finish the other.
We'll give her a moment. I think we've got quorum either way, so that's fine. I'll give it 30 seconds.
Staff was here. We've got Vesna, Sherry Klein is here.
Yep.
John Harry, Rudy, Cooper, and Charles.
Okay, no worries.
And Andrew Hamilton.
Yep. Okay, I can only see one councillor that's in this committee on my 9 screen, so I might need.
And me, I can see you,
Mayor. I can see Julie. I can see Graham and Maria, but aren't in the committee. Can't see Chad. Can't see Hood.
Members, you may want to have a look at the 3 dots in the top right corner. Click on that, and then scroll down, and then you'll be able to click on the together mode, which is an easier mechanism to see the members in the one gallery. So try that. So the 3 dots in the top right corner. Scroll down.
Adam, click together. You'll see us all sitting in chairs.
I have no option for together. Hang on.
That's the most ridiculous thing I've seen in a while. Together mode works for me. Yep.
All right. Look, we'll make do. I can't see all. I don't have any together mode on mine.
It's different. If you just look for the 3 dots, right?
Yeah, I am. There's no together mode.
And then where it's got change layout, press change layout. So the 3 dots and change layout.
No, mine does not have that.
Mine doesn't have change layout
or together mode.
No, mine doesn't have it. Look, that's okay.
Is it large gallery?
That's all right.
No, let's just get under large gallery. It says together mode.
It's all right. Let's just get going.
Which one do we want?
Okay.
Is it together mode?
Just forget it. All right. Now, have
we got CEO?
Councillor Woodman, quiet, please. Have we got Councillor Ook yet?
She's been admitted, but I can't see her on screen yet.
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, cool. No worries. All right, we'll get started.
Webcam on, Councillor Ook? Just a reminder.
Do you really want to see my face?
We want to see your face, Sarah.
He can on the ministerial notice requires us to be able to be seen at all times to be deemed to be present at the meeting.
Okay.
Fine.
Okay. All good. Let's just get going and we'll work it out as we go along. So I've got who's that screeching in the script?
Oh.
Come on, please figure that out. Is it the little para screen there? Okay, thank you.
Mr. Chairman, we've got Councillors Hood, the Mayor, who haven't pressed mute. Councillor Hood has. It's just the mayor. Everyone has now. Cool.
Gillian, can you please press mute? All right, we've gone through. We've heard the apologies. No leave of absence. Can we maybe mute that little power room?
Keep it on the bloody thing.
I think everything was fine till you came in, John.
Swear jar, John.
Okay, try again. Okay, no leave of absence. Just presentation of the minutes. Someone wish to move those?
I'm happy to move that way.
Moved by the mayor. Someone that second those? Councillor Woodman. Any discussion on those? Put that. All those in favour?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
We'll clear those. Carried. 501, future reports. Someone got to move those?
Happy to move.
Councillor Woodman, seconded by the mayor. Any discussion on those? Nope, with that, all those in favour? Against, carried. 511, community grants program applications for July. Someone want to move those? Use that information.
I'm having to move it.
Moved by Councillor Hood, seconded by the mayor. Any discussion on that one? Right, with that, put that. All those in favour? Against? Carried. We'll start with the grants, which is 512, the Marwan Soccer Club.
Mr. Chairman, if I may.
Councillor Buchanan.
Can I suggest we do May 1 at the end of the agenda? So I can declare an actual conflict. And then I'm happy to withdraw the next one, 513.
Yep. Okay, no problem. We'll move 512 down past 524. We'll go to 513. Move Councillor Buchanan. We've got a seconder. Councillor Hood.
No, I think Councillor Buchanan would like to withdraw.
Yeah, I saw you. You wish to second it.
That's fine. Yeah, I will second it.
Okay. No problem. Councillor Buchanan. Councillor Buchanan.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Chairman. Look, I'm more than happy to support the Mustard Seed Family Project. It's a great organisation doing a lot of great work. We've been pleased to be able to do our bit. A few of us have been helping them, with various community projects, and they've launched a community cafe at Ingle Farm. And, this grant will go a long way towards helping them to provide a lot of these services. So I know Councillor Hood was also a passionate supporter. So I thank Councillor Hood for seconding that. And I'm more than happy to move that grant application, Mr. Chairman.
Any other discussion on that one? I'll put that. All those in favour? Against? That's carried. 514, Brahma Lodge Sports Club. Thank you. I'll move that one, and Councillor Woodman can second that one. Any discussion on that one? Nope, we'll put that. All those in favour? Against? That's carried. 515, Mawson Lakes
Club.
The mayor like to move that. Someone like to second it.
Second it.
Councillor Hood, any discussion on that one? No, I put that. All those in favour? Against? That's carried. Five, 516, Mawson Lakes Probus Club. Someone like to move that one?
I'll move it.
Moved by the mayor. Seconded by Councillor Hood. Any discussion on that one? With that, put that. All those in favour? Against? That's carried. 517, the Parry Hills Night Soccer Club.
Yeah, I'm happy to move that one, Mr. Chairman. I know Councillor Genson was very keen.
Yeah, but, unfortunately he's not here. So Councillor Woodman, you're seconding it? Any discussion? Yes. Any discussion on that one? No, with that, all those in favour? Against? That's carried. 518 Salisbury Lions.
Yeah, happy.
Councillor Cannon, seconded by Councillor Woodman. Sure I think I heard it there.
Yes.
Discussions?
Sorry.
And I've just, it's not a conflict, but just for the record, I'd just like to know.
Again, that, with the background noise, can people please mute if they're not speaking? We've got that ringing again.
I think Councillor Reynolds got his hand up. Councillor Reynolds, you got your hand up.
Councillor Reynolds, are you wishing to contribute?
That's deliberate because I'd like to contribute, but when you're ready, Mr. Chair, as an observer.
Is there any other discussion from the committee? No, Councillor.
Happy to reserve my right at this stage. Yep.
Councillor Reynolds, go for it.
Thanks, Mr. Chair. Look, I appreciate I'm only an observer in this, but I'm having a look at the paperwork we have before us for this, and I'm just trying to work out what audit trail there is for all this. Now, the reason I say that is because if I look at the attachments, there's an unsigned letter, not dated. The request is for $7,000, and yet there is absolutely no indication of what makes up that $7,000. There is no costings for the event. If this was the carols or if this was any other event, and you can see with the other categories up higher, we ask people, for what are the costings? What contributes to that? My understanding as well is that people are being charged to attend this event, and that's okay. That's quite all right. I'm just looking at them going, the details you have before you, no signed letter, no costing for the event. How did the figure for $7,000 even come up with? Because it's not even in the letter saying they want $7,000. It's asked to be a non-discretionary bid for the next budget quarter review. This event's been planned at least since back to April when they bid for it, earlier than that even. I kind of wonder what planning went to hosting this, that they've planned all this convention without sorting out until this late stage, help with events and the rest of it. So, look, I'm an observer for this, but I'm just looking at it. And even if I say put an audit hat on, I'm struggling to see an auditable trail here of information and evidence that supports this bid.
Graham, can you mute yourself, Gillian, and a little para, please? Sorry.
Yes, please, Gillian, please mute. Gillian, before you walk away, can you please mute your device? If any of the staff there have got control. Yep. Okay. Good. Okay, Councillor Buchanan, you're going to comment.
Look, I hate to be difficult. Also, is do we have a quorum present?
I'm here.
We have myself. We have the mayor, Councillor Buchanan, Councillor Hood, Councillor Woman. Yes, we do.
Cool. Thanks. Look, Councillor Reynolds.
Mayor, can you please put your device onto mute, please? Gillian, please put your device onto mute. Okay, don't listen.
Need to mute yourself, Mayor.
Pardon?
Press mute.
You need to mute yourself.
If I mute myself, I can't hear what you're saying.
No, you can. I don't know what the deal is there. Might be the little power room getting the feedback.
All right, I'll just intervene there. Who's controlling the little power screen?
I mute myself. I can't hear what anyone's saying.
I've just muted everyone. Adam, can you unmute yourself so you can talk?
Thanks, Mr. Chairman. The Councillor Reynolds makes a number of valid points, and the way the motion is worded, given that we do have a non-discretionary bid, I'm happy to seek leave of the seconder and the meeting to make this part three subject to a budget being presented as part of the non-discretionary bid.
Okay, Okay. We've got some issues with the audio here. This is Gillian, you've come back off mute. You've got the little power room off mute and someone is whistling and it's just not workable here. Gillian, please mute the microphone. You don't need to mute the sound.
Yeah, that's better.
Okay.
That's fine.
So look, I'm happy to leave, Mr. Chairman, to vary that motion to make that subject to a budget being proposed. I do know from experience that the convention is actually going ahead. It is something that happens for our district. We're lucky that we're having the district the convention being held within the city, well, by one of our clubs hosting it, which is, I guess, full kudos to the Salisbury Lions Club. But Councillor Reynolds is right. We do need to make sure that, especially that it is a non-discretionary bid, that there is a budget attached to that and a proposed list of expenses. So with leave of the seconder, Mr. Chair.
Seconder agree to that?
No. I have fairly strong feelings about this. I see all the Rotaries and the other Lions all get money, and I do agree with Councillor.
Sorry, Mr. Chairman, I think Councillor Woodman was a seconder.
Yes, I thought I was. Yeah, and I'll be happy. Yeah, I'm happy with what's proposed at this point in time. It looks like it's an estimate of 7,000 that is our contribution.
Okay, so Julie, you're okay with the variation?
Yes.
Okay. All right, is the leave of the meeting, is everyone okay with that variation?
Through the chair, can the alternate motion or the varied motion please be confirmed? So we've got subject to, what are the words that we need to insert?
So, Mr. Chairman, it's that a non-discretionary first quarter, blah, 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 of up to... be authorised for up to 7,000 to contribute to the opening event, subject to a list of expenditure items and quotes as per the community grants guidelines requirements.
Okay, has everyone on that committee have understand that?
Happy with that.
Okay. All right. With that, then, I'll put the motion. Hands up, all those in favour.
Adam.
Charles.
Can I just clarify a couple of things before this put? So the 7,000 was an estimate. Obviously, the intent was to hold that opening, and majority of that 7,000 was an estimate based on about 5 to 6 for the catering. Some other items that might need to be required on the night. The intent is for us to fund that directly, so there's no way to receive from the Lions Club at this stage as we receive from a community grant. So it's an internal estimate based on, you know, catering per head for 100. We can provide further information, but at this stage there's no sort of formal quotes received as an estimate. So the proposed motion where it says subject, you know, up to and subject to a list of expenditure, we can provide it, but it's just more want to clarify that's an internal estimate rather than something from the Lions Club. Cater for a 100-person event.
Okay, I understand that. It might be for the benefit of transparent, this one. Is this one better? Maybe we can bring this back next week with some further information around that.
We can do that, Chair.
Yeah, I think for the benefit of this one, I think that's maybe what we'll do. So would we have to move this as deferred to next week, or can we just sort of roll it into next week with a bit of federal?
No, I think in the recommendation 3, you need to include back to council.
Did you hear that, Adam?
It cut out a little bit. Can you please repeat?
It's basically part 3, basically that a further information item will be presented to council for next month, this Monday coming.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The mover and the second happy to amend to reflect that.
Julie and Chad, are you happy to just amend that?
Yes.
Chad?
Thinking the wording. So instead of part 3, so part 3 will be that a further information item be presented to council at a July 2021 meeting,
Yeah, pretty much along the line.
Instead of the part three that's there.
Yeah, yeah. And I think that's what Charles just mentioned. And I think that's fine. Does everyone in the committee understand what the intent is of that change to part three? Okay. All right. We'll put that. All those in favour? Against? That's carried. We'll discuss that more next week. Where were we at? We were at 519 Salisbury Rec Precinct. Councillor Hood, you'll move that one. I'll second it. Any discussion on that one at this stage?
Just to give notice, I may move something different next week, but okay. I just thank staff for taking on board some of the suggestions made to make the public, information, promotional material a little bit more attractive and simplified. There probably is some minor changes we can make, which would be more administrative in nature, so I'm happy to pick that up. Next week at council.
Yep, no worries, all good. Anyone else wish to contribute? Nope, with that, all those in favour? Against? Julie, are you against or are you just a bit slow on your four? That's carried. Okay. 521, the Phoebe Wanganine, Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Scholarship. I'll be happy to move that one. Someone like to second it. Councillor Buchanan, any discussion on that one? With that, all those in favour? Again, that's carried.
Apologies, who's the seconder?
Councillor Buchanan is the seconder.
Can you repeat that again, please?
Councillor Buchanan, I moved it. Councillor Buchanan seconded that one. All good?
Yep.
Thank you. Okay, so we're up to 522. Response to the motion without notice, council support of volunteer organisations. I was going to ask, who actually put that motion through originally? Do you remember? I couldn't remember who put that. In regards to how council can further support volunteer organisations by advertising events and things. Do we know who?
Councillor Reardon put that forward.
Okay. Will someone here like to move that? Councillor Buchanan. Seconded by Councillor Woodman. Any discussion on that one?
Yes, I've got a question.
Councillor Hood.
In the report, it says about we're going to use our external screens to advertise for our volunteers and their organisations. And it says here back in May there was 100 events, such events. And if you read the report, it says they're only going to advertise 3 events per month on our video screening. And I read how they, the peak bodies, what the questions are asked. But with that, I would like to know how do they judge which 3 they're going to use for the month? If there's up to 100 events in that month.
That's a good question. Any of the managers wish to sort of answer that? Bessie? Yeah, Bessie, go ahead.
Through the chair, we have requested for organisations that they
I unmuted myself. Yeah.
That's right, Bess. Just persevere, see how you go.
I will.
Keep going.
Hopefully you can hear me without noise. Okay. Yeah. Do you want to meet Martin?
Better now?
Yeah, keep going. That's fine.
So one of the recommendations in the report is to have an expression of interest where we have a number of different criteria how we will select. Make sure that one organization is not actually selected 3 times per month, so all the organizations have access. So we'll be able to select organizations that provide materials and also that our vision and mission, and make sure that they have also filling all the appropriate information. For example, that they need to lodge a request. I think that's they will need to provide information and collateral display. They will also guidelines and our social media guidelines. So that 100 of events actually show the amount of different ways that volunteer organizations support, but we definitely won't be able to support all, but support the major one there. And smaller ones that actually provide service to community.
Thanks for that, Vesna. It's all right. She did give a pretty good explanation of how it would get rotated fairly and stuff like that. So I think we'll talk further about next week and hopefully we may be in person. Might be a bit easier. All good. Anyone else wish to just contribute? Nope. We'll put that then. All those in favour? Against? That's carried. Where are we? 523, White Ribbon, whole community response.
I'll move that one.
Okay. I think we had the mayor first, and then seconded by Councillor Woodman. Any discussion on that one?
No.
Was that all those in favour? Against? Carried. 524, the youth sponsorship applications for June 20. Moved by Councillor Hood. I'm happy to second those ones. Any discussion on those? With that, all those in favour? Against, carried. And bringing back 512 May 1 Soccer Club Incorporated. Councillor Buchanan, you've got a conflict of interest.
Yeah, I'll wait till someone moves and seconds and I'll do that.
Okay, someone wish to move that one?
I'll move it.
Moved by the Mayor, seconded by Councillor Hood. Councillor Buchanan, you got a...
Thanks, Mr Chairman. I just wish to declare an actual conflict of interest on the basis that May 1 Soccer Club are a sub-leasee of a sporting club that I'm an office bearer of. And I will... You there, Rudy?
Yes.
And I'll handle this actual conflict of interest by... I don't know, do I disconnect myself? Do I press the red button or...?
If you were to decide, Councillor Buchanan, to remove yourself and not participate in the debate nor vote, you can switch your camera off, and from here we should be able to exclude you from the meeting.
So what do I do? Do I just press the
button?
Alternatively, since this is an actual conflict of interest, you have also other mechanisms available, such as, for example, deciding not to participate in the debate and not voting, but still being present. That's also an option for your consideration.
Look, given that that's just the information, if it was an act to do with the granting the money, yeah. I may have left. But given that we're just simply noting that the application's ineligible because they didn't fill out all the details, surprise, surprise, I will... make it easier because I don't know which buttons to press here. I'll just not vote and I won't debate.
Yep, fair enough. That's fine. Okay, all good. Is there any other discussion?
Do I still remove myself from the camera or what do I
No, just mute yourself at least. Okay, any other discussion on that one? No.
Just has administration done their absolute best to follow up with the soccer club to why the application was incomplete and also ran out of time.
Carl, you want to chat about that one?
Through you, Chair. Yeah, there's been a number of contacts made with the club and also letters sent to the secretary back in March and also the last one back on the 7th of July. There's various attempts been made to get the information.
Also, with that now, can the council work with this soccer club to reapply so they know what to do and how to go about it?
Through your chair, we already have had that, even when Ronnie was still here, worked a lot with the club. We can continue to do so that, you know, they can resubmit another application, but we have done to date already.
as the application shown on the thing, there's not much information is being provided by the club, but we can make contact with them again if it's required.
Yes, thank you.
Any other discussion? No. With that, I'll put that. All those in favour? Against? Carried. Have we got any other business? Nope, all good. With that, we'll close the meeting at 7:11 p.m. Thank you all.
Stay safe, everybody, and enjoy the lockdown.
All right, look after yourselves, people. I'll see you next week, hopefully.